Last week I built a bookshelf with a pattern carved in the side. In that video I used a paper template to lay out the pattern. So this week I'm going to show you how I made the template from getting the drawings out of SketchUp, getting them into Adobe Illustrator, scaling them to the right size, and prepping them to be printed. Okay, so we're in SketchUp and we got our bookshelf all loaded up. And the first thing we want to do is get rid of this gray background. So I'm going to go to Windows, Default Tray. Make sure styles is checked, hit show tray, and then we're just going to pick one out of the styles menu that has a white background to clean that up. And then basically we want to take a screenshot of our pattern here. So I want to get rid of the rest of the bookshelf, so I'm just going to select this component and hold down the control key and just go around and click on all of these parts to get them selected. All right, control copy, click out of the component, control V. All right, and there we go. So I am going to select the bookcase, right click hide, and then hit Q on the keyboard. Whoops, first I'm going to spacebar to get my selection tool and select all that, then hit Q on the keyboard. Turn it down this way so I can zoom in as close as possible. I'm going to go up here and hit the side view just to get a straight on view of it. Spacebar to get my selection tool and just click outside to deselect it. All right, so then that looks pretty good. So I'm going to go File, Export, 2D Graphic. All right, so I'm going to save it in a convenient place. Before I X out of here, I'm going to just take some measurements. It's 13 inches wide and 42 3/8 inches long. All right, so exit out of here. I'm going to fire up Adobe Illustrator. I'm going to hit Create New, which brought up this box here. And I want to make sure that I am in inches. I think the default is pixels, but you want to make sure you're in inches so when you print it to scale, it will scale it properly. So 8.5 by 11 is the paper size I'm going to use to print. And then we're going to do a little math to figure out how many sheets of paper we need. And we're going to need 8 for this. So hit Create. And there's our 8 sheets of paper. In Illustrator, they call them artboards. Now, most printers don't print all the way to the edge of the paper. There's always a little bit of line there. So we need to overlap the paper. So to do that, I'm going to click over here on the left, this artboard tool. And up here it says Arrange All. So I'm going to click that. And I want an overlap of 1 inch. So I'm going to hit -1 so that way it'll space the artboards out -1 inch. So they'll overlap by 1 inch. And I want them to go over and down like that. 2 columns. And then hit OK. And so now there's all our paper if we were to have them taped together. So I'm going to go File, Place, and get my template here. My pattern. And hit Place. And bring it in. And so now it's not scaled. So I'm going to Control Plus to zoom in, and then I'm going to trace the image. So we're going to basically turn it into a vector. So I'm going to, on the right hand side, the Image Trace tool. If that's not there, you can go Windows, Image Trace, and it'll bring it up over here. So I'm going to go ahead and hit Trace, and it's not very clear. So I'm going to click the Advanced Settings. Click the strokes box. That'll darken it up a little bit. And then I'm just going to use these to slowly toggle. Use these little sliders to slowly bring up the sharpness. All right, so I've played with all the sliders and I got it looking pretty good. So now I'm going to turn it into a vector. So I'm going to hit expand. And there we go. I'm going to go to the properties tab. And if the Properties tab is not there, you can go to Windows and make sure that's checked, Properties, and it'll pop up over here. Use the Selection tool up here. Select that. and I'm going to rotate it 90 degrees. So over here on the right hand side, type in 90, enter, zoom out so I can see it a little better. So now we need to scale it. So we have right here our width and height on the right hand side. I'm going to untoggle that to make sure I'm linked. And then we're going to change this to 13 inches. And it scaled up 13 inches wide and 42.2 inches high. So it actually is a little bit off. It scaled at 42.2 and it was 42 3/8 inches tall. Click the break the chain so I can just change this to 42.375. Hit enter and then it stretched it out just a little bit to make it perfectly scaled. So now we're just going to move it onto our artboard here. And I miscalculated the number of pages with that 1 inch overlap. It took up more space than what I was thinking. So I'm going to go to artboards and down here on the bottom right, just hit add new artboard. So it's going to add two more artboards. Go back over here to the left and click the artboard tool, rearrange all. And we still have our settings in there, two columns wide with a 1 inch overlap. Hit OK. And boom, there we go. Now when we print this, we need a way to make sure we're accurately lining up the pages when we tape them together. So I'm going to zoom in here. I'm going to draw a square. Hold the shift key down, it'll draw a perfect square. If you don't hold the shift key down, you'll be able to draw a rectangle. I'm just going to draw a square just to give me a starting point. And in the properties on the right hand side, I'm just going to link that and I'm going to make it a half inch square. So type in 0.5. All right, get my selection tool and I'm going to use the arrow keys just to arrow it up to line it up with the edge. Line that up there. Looks good. So then oops, it disappeared. I'm going to change the stroke on that to black. Then I'm just going to draw a line, hold the shift key. Draw a line from here. Shift key, and I'm going to change that to 1 inch. Use my arrow to line it up. Now I'm just going to delete that rectangle. Just to make it a little more obvious, I'm going to draw a circle here. So right in the center, I'm going to start to draw. And if I hold the Alt key down, it'll center that. And if I hold the Shift key down at the same time as the Alt key, it'll make it a perfect circle. Then I'm going to right click, arrange, send to back. That'll send it all the way to the back. There we go. Now we have a little bullseye to line everything up. So I'm going to select all that, right click group. I'm going to hold down the Alt key so that way when I drag it over here, it'll make a copy of it. And then I'm going to hold the Shift key down at the same time so it locks it into that vertical plane. So that way I know they're perfectly aligned. Too far zoomed in. Grab it, hold the Shift key down. All right, zoom out here. Get both those. I'm going to click on this one, hold the Shift key down, click on that one, and then hold the Alt key down to grab it. Hold the Shift key down again, and just copy those down to each one. Hold the Alt key down, start to drag. We'll start holding the Shift key down, it locks it in place. Super simple. All right, and then I just realized I should put one right here in the center where the center overlaps. So I'm just going to select that, hold the Shift key down, and scroll down, selecting all of these. And then I'm going to hold the Alt key down to copy those as I move them, hold the Shift key down, and just put it right in the center. There we go. Now we have one all in the center. Grab this one, click it, select it, hold the Alt key down to make a copy of it. Move, hold the Shift key down to lock it in place. And boom. All right, we're done. All right, so now to make sure it prints to scale, I'm going to select my rectangle tool. Hold the Shift key down and draw a rectangle. Go over here to the Properties tab and just make it a one inch square. So that way when I print it, I can double check my measurements. All right, so that looks pretty good. Got our layout lines and a square to check scale. So then I'm gonna go File, Save As. And I'm going to go here and go down to save as a PDF. Save it. Right, and then there's our PDF broken down into pages. So all you have to do is print it from here. So you hit print. And then you want to make sure on page sizing, you will have actual size highlighted. So that way it prints to scale. It's printed. Print. And you're done.